Each year, I-MED Radiology impacts millions of lives, providing the highest quality healthcare and medical imaging. We give patients and their doctors answers that reduce uncertainty, answers they can trust. Welcome to Inside I-MED, where we'll be diving into the extraordinary capabilities of radiology imaging, exploring innovations, and introducing you to the amazing individuals working behind the scenes at I-MED Radiology. Discover the power of breast imaging in the fight against breast cancer as we delve into an exclusive interview with one of our experienced mammographers, unveiling the key differences between breast screening and diagnostic mammography. Before we do, make sure you subscribe to the I-MED Radiology YouTube channel for more content. Let's dive in.
So screening mammography in Australia is done through BreastScreen. This is a free national screening program with the aim of reducing the burden of breast cancer on the community. This program targets the assumably healthy population, or basically people without any active breast-related symptoms. Women from 40 onwards can get a free mammogram every 2 years. However, the ideal target population are women between 50 and 74. Because it is a screening program on asymptomatic patients, they are limited in the amount of images or projections taken, as there needs to be a greater benefit than harm, which in this case is radiation, for the patient for it to be justifiable. So diagnostic mammograms do differ in a few aspects to screening mammography. The main one is that a patient will have symptoms, so for example, a breast lump. They would seek out a diagnostic pathway via getting a referral from their GP. Because we are a diagnostic practice and are investigating active symptoms, we are justified in taking more images for a more thorough investigation. Most commonly, we would use tomosynthesis mammography as opposed to breast screen using conventional mammography at their initial appointments. And also diagnostic mammograms are also taken in conjunction with ultrasound. And sometimes we may even progress to a same day biopsy if the results are concerning. So first and foremost, patients should expect to be made to feel as comfortable as possible. A lot of time, first time patients come in with anxiety because they hear things from friends and family that they may not like, but it is definitely not as bad as people believe. As a mammographer, we have an ethical duty to our patients to ensure they are as comfortable as possible and not in any pain during the procedure. We will give our patients gowns before the mammogram, but however, patients should expect to be topless for the actual mammogram procedure. The machine is very sensitive to artifacts, and small things such as dust or hair can mimic pathology. The breast is then compressed between a paddle and a detector. The compression is uncomfortable, but it shouldn't be painful. The mammographer should always be checking in with the patient to make sure that they're tolerating the pressure given. The most important thing for the procedure is for the mammographer and the patient to both have open, flowing communication. That's probably the biggest key factor in a successful mammogram procedure for both patient comfort and their resultant images. So mammography is a very user-dependent modality. BreastScreen have developed a very strict grading system to determine whether an image taken is acceptable or not. The quality assurance and the quality control required of a mammographer is quite high due to the importance of early detection. It's very important to get as much breast tissue as possible on all projections taken. Missing anatomy can lead to missing pathology, which is just detrimental to a patient prognosis. As a mammographer, there are many key factors involved in getting the best images possible. The first one is gaining a patient's trust. If the patient's comfortable with us, they're more likely to be relaxed and better talked through the procedure. A second thing is to realize that no two breasts are the same. So our knowledge of how to manipulate both the machinery and the patient, depending on their body habitus, is what's needed to achieve the best pictures possible. So a lot of breast cancers can be asymptomatic until they have progressed or metastasized. If a breast cancer is detected early, so small and localized, the 5-year survival rate can be as high as 98%. So diagnosing a breast cancer early results in more options being available to the patient and thus a better prognosis. So overall, the importance of detecting and excising the cancer before it advances can literally mean the difference between surviving or not.
Join us for an insightful interview as one of our experienced CT radiographers sheds light on CT calcium scoring. Discover how this test can estimate the future risk of a heart attack or stroke for asymptomatic individuals.
A CT calcium score is a really great test to look at any buildup of plaques or calcified disease in the arteries of the heart, which is an early sign of heart disease. Risk factors include smoking, lifestyle factors such as diet and exercise, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, and family history of heart disease. So generally anyone over 40 who meets any of those risk factors is a good candidate for one of these tests. A CT calcium score test is minimally invasive, so it basically requires very minimal preparation and is a very quick study versus other heart tests which are more invasive. Generally, we do a calcium score test for patients who have no symptoms and would like a general health check, whereas patients for other more invasive tests normally have a symptom that their doctor is requiring investigation for. So when you come in for a CT calcium score, we will ask you to have no caffeine for 24 hours before your study. That helps us keep your heart rate nice and low and get clear pictures of the heart when we're doing our scan. You will need to get changed into a gown on the day. We'll prep your skin with a little bit of gel, and then we'll pop some heart monitoring leads on your chest for the duration of the procedure. Then you'll move in and out of the CT scanner, which is a donut-shaped gantry with a bed that moves in and out. You'll be told to breathe in and hold your breath a few times, and generally all up, it's finished within 10 minutes of the study. Calcium score is a really great test that finds early signs of heart disease before you might be showing symptoms. The benefit is that we can catch these things early before it does progress to more serious disease, and your doctor can start managing that to minimize the future risk of heart attack. There is limitations to this study. You can have coronary buildup of plaques in your heart. They don't always calcify though. So as you get older, these plaques do start to calcify, and we can see them on this screening test of the calcium score. But there is a chance that there is things that we do miss on this test because it is a quick, easy study. So if you do have symptoms of chest pain or a strong family history, they might consider doing other tests if you do have a high score on this study. Yep, so if you're concerned about your heart health or any risk factors that you might have for coronary artery disease, speak to your GP and they can write you a referral to get one of these investigations done. As I've said, it is a really quick, easy test to get this investigated, and then that way you can have the peace of mind knowing that your heart health is good for the future.
We hope you've gained valuable insights into the incredible capabilities of diagnostic imaging at I-MED Radiology. Remember to always speak to your healthcare provider about any health concerns you have so that they can arrange the most appropriate test for you. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more informational content.